You know what Musa will say? I can't. فَإِنِّي Why? Why يا موسى؟ فَإِنِّي قَتَلْتُ نَفْسًا لَمْ أُمَرْ بِقَتْلِهَا Because I killed someone I was not asked to kill. And pay attention here. Look at this. He killed him accidentally. قتل خطأ. Two individuals are fighting. He wanted to separate them. He put his hand on him. He killed him. Accidentally. Be careful. Musa's killing of the Egyptian was not intentional. Was قتل خطأ. No intention there. This is one. He killed a kafir, a non-Muslim. Three, that non-Muslim was attacking the Muslim. That's three. He was the attacker. فَاسْتَغَاثَهُ الَّذِي هُوَ فَاسْتَغَاثَهُ الَّذِي مِنْ شِيَعَتِهِ عَلَى الَّذِي مِنْ عَدُوٍ Help me, Musa. This guy is beating me up. Help me. So he's trying to help the Muslim. Number four, Allah forgiving him in the dunya. قَالَ رَبِّ اغْفِرْ لِي فَغَفَرَ لَهُ He said, Oh Allah, forgive me. You're forgiven, ya Musa. Yet, he still recall it in the land of gathering. He still remember it. What about you driving a truck into some people who are biking or jogging? What animosity you have with them? What did they do to you? They are not even wrong in a Muslim. A lot of these people, if they hear this da'wah of Islam, they accept that religion. But that's not a criteria either. Even if they insist on their disbelief, they are entitled to their lives. Ya ikhwa, subhanallah, the killer, he may get caught in the dunya. And, you know, sometimes for him to come out of this, he has to ransom. Fidiyah in Islam. You could ransom. He can be executed for killing. That's the punishment in Islam. But you want to know something? This is all for the family. In order to remove that anger out of their chests. But the one who is killed, still in the day of judgment, is not over. Look at this athar. Abdullah ibn Abbas was asked, Ya ibn Abbas, O ibn Abbas, al-athar fi al-Nasa'i, Sunan al-Nasa'i, al-qatil tawbah. The one who kills, he has a chance. You know what he said? Fakalathu ummu. May his mother lose him. That's a term. That's he's a loser. سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول I heard the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم says يأتي المقتول يوم القيامة The one who was killed in the day of judgment will come. Look at the scene. يحمل رأسه على يديه carrying his head on his hand. تشخب أوداجه دما The veins of his neck are pouring blood in the land of gathering. يجر قاتلا Dragging his killer with the other hand. And he will go stand in front of Allah and he will say, يا رب سل هذا فيما قتلني Ask him why he killed me. Why? Why did he strip me out of my life? The life that you placed in my body, and no one is, hatta your own, even you cannot take your life out. You have to wait until Allah commands an angel called the angel of death to come, sleep, let's take it out. You can't. What we call suicide. You cannot. You have to, even if you're going through hell in this dunya, even if you're going through depression, you don't have money, You're miserable. You can't. You can't take your life out. You can't. من قتل نفسه بحديدة فهو يضرب به من رمى نفسه من قتل نفسه بسم حديث أبي هريرة في الصحيح معروف that whoever kills himself he's gonna keep killing himself in the grave and in the hellfire he will keep doing this ولا تقتلوا أنفسكم في القرآن ف you can't بعدين look at this hadith حديث في البخاري أخرجه الإمام البخاري حديث عبد الله بن عمر رضي الله عنهما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم the prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says لا يزال المسلم في فسحة من دينه ما لم يصب دما حرام a Muslim's states for salvation يعني. That's the essence of the words يعني your chance to go to Jannah to succeed in the test are very high until you hit this sin until you indulge yourself into that sin that you kill another person then your chances are what شوف ابن عمر always likes to comment look what he said commenting on this hadith وإن من ورقات الأمور لمن أوقع نفسه فيها سفك الدم بغير حلم One of the greatest masses that a person may find himself in, masses that you kill somebody without a reason. فهذه نصوص. I just want to say that هذه نصوص. يا إخوة, we believe in our religion, in our jurisprudence, that sometimes if you end up doing haram, being compelled, being forced, you're not a sinner. If you do things out of ikrah, hadith in Sunan Abi Dawud, hadith Aisha, Allah has pardoned my ummah for the things that they do before they reach the age of puberty, the things that they do because of insanity, the things that they do, if we put both wording together, the things that they do out of forgetfulness, and the things that they do being forced. But what about killing? No. No. If I give you a gun and I ask you to shoot this guy, and I tell you that if you don't shoot him, I'm gonna shoot you. If you don't shoot him, I'm gonna shoot you. You can't shoot him. You cannot. If you shoot him, you're a killer. You're a killer. You have a choice between you and his. يعني في قصة I shared with the brothers in Fajr this morning, interesting out of this world. You know there is a guy by the name of الحجاج ابن يوسف الثقفي. If you read about الحجاج, he's very similar to like these guys that we have these rulers of our time. Without naming anybody. Wallahi, they don't deserve to be named on that place. Who killed them, their people for power, for office. Bomb their own people to stay in office, you know. Al-Hajjaj was known of that. He killed actually companions. The scholar spoke about him. Some of them said he's a kafir, some of them said he's a fasiq. But I really respect so much what Al-Hafidh al-Dhahabi mentioned about him regarding his status in a book called Sir Alam al-Nubala. He said something very fascinating. He said, له حسنات في محيطات سيئاته. He has good deeds in the ocean of his bad deeds. He has good deeds in the ocean of what? And this is one of the situations. He sent his guy, go get me Abdullah ibn Umar. Abdullah ibn Umar, the son of Umar ibn Khattab. You know he lived long life, Abdullah ibn Umar. Get Abdullah ibn Umar to me. Abdullah ibn Umar was blind. He got blinded. So his son Salim would take his hand. So Salim, يا ابني تعالى خذ يا سالم, let's go to الحجاج, we're going to be in trouble. Subhanallah, they arrived when الحجاج was so angry at a man. He's arguing with him and so angry. So when he saw Salim, the son of Abdullah ibn Umar said, Salim, come here, take this guy and kill him. Remember the ruling now. And if you don't do it, guess what? Al-Hajjaj is going to get you. Big time. So Salim said, can I please do this outside? Say, yeah, go ahead. So Salim took him, walked out. So he asked the man, هَلْ صَلَّيْتَ الصُّبْحَ فِي جَمَاعَةٍ? Did you pray Fajr in Jama'ah? He said, yes. قَالَ خُذْ أَيَّ طَرِيقٍ شِئْ. يَلَّا, run away. اهرب. So he came back to the court of al-Hajjaj. What did you do with the man? He said, I let him go. Why? حَدَّثَنِي أَبِي. My father told me that he heard the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, whoever prays Fajr in Jama'ah, فَهُوَ فِي ذِمَّةِ اللَّهِ. He's under the protection of Allah. So how do you want me to kill someone who's under the protection of Allah? Al-Hajjaj looked at him as if, you got me. Yeah, that's the hasana in the ocean of, the, you got me. That's what Islam teaches, brothers and sisters in Islam.